Hey, horse people. This is my first video I'm doing while I'm driving down the highway. So I figured this should get the helmet people riled up. I don't have a helmet on. I'm driving a car at 70 miles an hour and I'm making a video. Oh, Rick, that's dangerous. All right, so here's a scoop. It irritates the crap out of me when people neglect their horses. But there's always this dilemma on whether you get involved or you ignore it and mind your own business. And normally I tell people, mind your own business. It never turns out good. It's just bad. When you try to help, it's going to turn out bad. Well, there's this one little horse that I pass every day. He's in a field. Nobody sees him. His hooves are split. He hangs out always trying to crawl to other horses because he's lonely. He's kept by himself. So every once in a while, I stop by and give him a little cookie. So I noticed for the last couple months that his halter has been getting tighter and tighter and tighter. And I know nobody handles the horse, so I'm like, okay, this thing's going to grow in his nose. Well, today, I stopped to give him a cookie, and either the fur or because he's grown, it looked really bad. So I said, screw it. I went ahead and I took his halter off. Now, I know I shouldn't have. I know it ain't my horse. I know somebody's going to be crying. If that was my horse, I would call the police and have you arrested. Shut up. Oh, shit. Almost missed my exit. So, anyway, look, I took the halter off because it was growing into the horse's face. When I took it off, the poor little thing was hurting. It was on the last loop. It was one of those freaking pretty red things that was cute when he was a baby, and now it's grown into his nose, and it left a big old mark, and his nose has this indention on it. And I was just like, oh, I wanted to bring the halter to the people and go, you know what, I took this off and your horse has an indention and it's not good, and it's starting to grow in his fur. All his fur is gone here where it's like cutting. It's just starting to cut. He's got like little light scabs, so it hasn't really grown in. But anyway, I took it off and I hung it on the fence. And now I'm telling the world I did it, but I'm not telling the people I did it. So, and you know what? I've gotten a jam before where I go out there and I see some horse at a barn, either I was training at or something. The horse has the blanket half off, wrapped around its leg. He's standing in the corner shaking. It's caught. It's choking him. It's going to cause him an abscess. And you know what? I took that off too. And sometimes it worked out okay. Somebody said thanks. You know, a couple people said thanks, appreciate it. You know, I didn't want my horse to do that. Other people, you don't touch my, that was my blanket. And I don't ever touch my horse with my blanket because he needs it. And now if my horse gets cold and gets sick, it's going to be your, shut up. Get on your broom and fly out of here. All right. That's my first video while I'm driving. Y'all have a good one.